I know you're frightened. You're terribly frightened by what you've seen. But I'm not gonna lie to you. Your friends are not prepared for this fight. Hawkins will fall.
My friends need me.
You're not ready.
He's not going to stop. Not until he's taken everyone.
Let's do it.
But I have this terrible feeling. It might not work out for us this time.
If you've enjoyed season four up until this point, like, get ready, because it's the last 4 hours are the best thing. It makes what you've seen look like chump change compared to it. It is a masterpiece. In my mind, it's a masterpiece. It's beautiful. It's epic. It's emotional, but it's also on a scale and a scope that almost gets silly in its like wondrous, almost manga-esque, and I think that's the true magic of Stranger Things. Is it, you know, we did it in season three with the never-ending story sequence, and we do a bunch of that in the finale too, where it's like you have these moments that are so tense and so rich and so emotional, and then you sort of heighten them even more by having two kids sing a song while you're trying to get a code for a safe, you know. And I think it's truly magical. So I think those kids are real geniuses, and if you've enjoyed season four up to this far, you're going to be blown away on July 1st.
Can you tell us anything about the finale?
Oh my God. It's a zeitgeist. I've never been a part of anything like this, and it has been 7 years of this, so I've gotten used to what it means and my place in it. It's, you know, very gratifying to be a part of something that's touched so many people and so many young people. You know, I always thought I'd be, you know, I'm 47, I always thought I'd be, have some career of like, you know, art films that would maybe like, you know, appeal to old people, and suddenly I have a fan base of like 13, like I can't walk past the middle school without like being harassed. So it's a very strange thing for me to be a part of.
It is over. Now I just want you to watch. Your friends have lost.